Yet again, Dragon Ball Super is not making sense. Really? 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 They're gonna be having Dyspo versus Hit. Are you kidding me, really? The same Dyspo that ended up getting captured by a little treehouse of horror plant monster and was about to get eaten if Casserole and Topo didn't step in and save him. And really, and also he took on base form Kaba and was actually fighting him until that robot looking thing knocked them both away. And I'm thinking, okay, first of all, you get knocked both away and you're gonna fight a base form Kaba, which is way, way, way weaker than Hit. And you're telling me that Dyspo is going to be taking on Hit? Come on now. You know what Hit's been through when it comes to tough fighters? Just like, okay, Goku went Super Saiyan Blue, Kaioken, times 10, and was like tearing into him. Even when it ended up actually stopping his time skip for a bit, the way that he was able to punch through it. And he also stopped the Kamehameha technique and also ended up improving through that. And you're kidding me, after all these improvement techniques that Hit has done, you're telling me that Dyspo is like way faster than all that stuff? Because they said that he's like supposed to be considered the speedster of the Pride Troopers. And I'm thinking, okay, if you sacrifice speed for power, then what can you do when it comes to actually trying to even think about taking on Hit? I mean, he is a joke. First impressions by far mean something. And his first impression of what happened were that he wasn't fast enough to get away from the plant monster. He ended up getting caught and he wasn't strong enough to break out of those tentacles. And he had to get saved. I mean, first impressions are crucial. And he played a horrible job in doing that, really. And yeah, he can take on Hit, really. The person that defeated Goku easily. And also ended up knocking Goku out of his Super Saiyan Blue form. And also made Goku tremble in fear because he didn't actually really know if he was actually going to survive a battle between Hit. And you're telling me that this guy's going to be mean anything to him? Really? I mean, what has he got? What has he done? You know, that's almost like seemed like, oh, out of the blue, he's got a tremendous amount of training to where he came more and more stronger and faster within a little short amount of time. Which I didn't actually really see no training, and also he is by far one of the weakest members of the Pride Troopers, and to be honest, I kind of wish he would have gotten out much sooner because he hasn't really done nothing really. He hasn't eliminated anyone in the tournament, and you're telling me that he's going to be taking on Hit. Really? Dude, really, even if you stop the time skip, he can also improve still, and also he's extremely fast and powerful without his time skip, and you're telling me that he's going to have trouble with just this one guy? I'm sorry, it has to be a little tag team before Goku shows up to try to help him in his Super Saiyan God form, which kind of doesn't make sense because Super Saiyan God was supposed to be absorbed into his base form, and now they have the way that he can transform into it. Really? How? Seriously? Maybe Dyspo can transform. I don't know. I mean, it doesn't really make sense the way that he's actually going to be tearing into Hit. I know that because I seriously doubt he's fast enough to do that. But yeah, we'll have to see because apparently they're having the word that Dyspo does fight Hit and does great And apparently he is actually having trouble with this guy, even though it doesn't make complete sense. This fellow is a joke and he shouldn't even stay in the same ring as Hit.